Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy-to-understand whiteboard videos, and today I'll be sharing with you the difference between types of neural networks. Or, to be specific, the difference between ANN, CNN, and RNN. So, let's get started. First one, Artificial Neural Network, or ANN. Well, it is a group where we have multiple perceptrons or neurons at each layer and is also known as feed-forward neural network because inputs are processed only in forward direction. This type of neural networks are the ones which are simplest variants of neural networks as they pass information in one direction through various input nodes until it makes to the output node. This type of neural network may or may not have hidden node layers, making their functioning more interpretable. Some of the advantages of Artificial Neural Network or ANN include: number 1, they store information on the entire network. Number 2, they have the ability to work with incomplete knowledge. Number 3, they offer fault tolerance and have distributed memory. Number 4, they offer us the ability to work with incomplete knowledge. Likewise, the disadvantages include: number 1, they have huge hardware dependency. Number 2, they sometimes have unexpected behavior which can leave us tormented with results. Number 3, there is no specific rule for determining the structure of an artificial neural network, and appropriate network structure is achieved through experience and trial and error. Next on the list, Convolutional Neural Network or CNN. Now, they are one of the most popular models used today. This type of neural network computation model uses a variation of multi-layer perceptrons and contains one or more convolutional layers that can either be entirely connected or pooled. Further, these convolutional layers create feature maps that record a region of image which is ultimately broken into rectangles and are sent out for non-linear processing. Some of the advantages of using convolutional neural networks or CNN include: number 1, they offer very high accuracy in image recognition problems. Number 2, they are capable of automatically detecting important features without any human supervision. Number 3, weight sharing. Likewise, the disadvantages include: number 1, CNNs do not encode the position and orientation of the object. Number 2, they lack the ability to be spatially invariant to the input data. Number 3, a lot of training data is required in order for it to work efficiently. Next and last one on the list, Recurrent Neural Network or RNNs. Now, these are a lot more complex than the ones we discussed so far. They save the output of the processing nodes and feed the result back into the model, and hence they do not pass the information in one direction only. Further, this is how the model is set to learn to predict the outcome of a layer. Here, each node in the RNN model acts as a memory cell, continuing the computation and implementation of operations, and if the network's prediction is incorrect, then the system self-learns and continues working towards the correct prediction during backpropagation. Some of the advantages of recurrent neural networks or RNNs include: number 1, an RNN remembers each and every information through time. It is useful in time series prediction only because of this feature to remember previous inputs as well. This is also called as long short-term memory. Number 2, recurrent neural networks are even used with convolutional layers to extend the effective pixel neighborhood. Likewise, some of the disadvantages include: number 1, they have gradient vanishing and exploding problems. Number 2, training an RNN is a very difficult task. Number 3, they cannot process very long sequences if using TANH or ReLU as an activation function. Next, let's summarize the differences between ANN, CNN, and RNN in a tabular format. Number 1, ANNs operate on tabular or text data, whereas CNNs operate on image data and RNNs operate on sequence data. Number 2, parameter sharing is not possible in ANNs, whereas it is possible in CNNs and RNNs. Number 3, ANNs and RNNs operate on fixed length input, whereas RNNs don't. Number 4, recurrent connections are not possible in ANNs and CNNs, whereas in RNNs, they can be achieved. Number 5, spatial relationships are only possible in CNNs and not in ANNs and RNNs. Number 6, ANN is considered to be less powerful than CNN and RNN, whereas CNN is considered to be more powerful than ANN and RNN, and in terms of performance, RNN includes less feature compatibility when compared to CNN. Number 7. The main advantages of ANN include having fault tolerance and ability to work with incomplete knowledge. Whereas in CNNs, there is a high accuracy in image recognition problems and it offers weight sharing. Further, a RNN remembers each and every information and offers time series prediction. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.